Grace, mercy, and peace, beloved, and welcome to the New Unity Baptist Church broadcast. We are the equipping ministry, empowering the people of God for the work of the kingdom. Our pastor is Reverend Johnny Napoleon Golden Sr. We are so blessed to have you join us in worship today. Thank you, and let's begin worship.
Well, bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Do trust and pray that you're doing well this morning. New Unity and all of our friends who are joining us by social media or whatever platform you're in. This is Pastor Johnny Golden of the New Unity Baptist Church here in the great city of Baltimore, Maryland. How has your week been? I trust and pray that you've had a wonderful week. Yes, we are here fulfilling the mandate, the unseen and the unheard revealed to the people of God. Great destination beyond the veil. It is through our prophetic ministries of prayer, preaching, praise, and pedagogy. I want you to say that with me. Would you please write it down if you care to, but say it with me. It is throughout these four P's. Say them with me, please. It is through our prophetic ministry of prayer. Say prayer. Come on, prayer. And through preaching. Come on, say preaching. Praise. Praise and pedagogy. What is that, Pastor Golden? Simply, it's just a fancy way of saying teaching the words of Christ that we, the New Unity Baptist Church of Baltimore, Maryland, here on the eastern seaboard of the United States of America, seek to do the work of the kingdom. Oh, I'm feeling good in my spirit this morning. Amen. It's a bright, sunshiny day here in the East Coast. Amen. I almost said it's fall, but it's still winter time. Amen. We're enjoying the blessings of the Lord, and the Lord is, come on, it's just so good, isn't it? Come on, just sing this little line with me, would you please? The Lord is blessing me right now. Can you just say that? And even if you don't, even if it's not the case, at least you don't feel like it. I guarantee you, by the time we say it the second time, something's going to start ruminating in your belly. I just say your stomach in your belly. Amen. You're going to feel it. The Lord is blessing me right now. Right now, I can feel his mercy as before him I bow. I may not be able to see what he done for me, but the Lord is blessing me right now. Right now, say it again. The Lord is blessing me right now. Right now, I can feel his mercy, yes, before him I bow. I may not be able to see what he done for me, but the Lord is blessing me right now. Right now. Amen. We're preparing now for the ministry of prayer. Now, Deacon Denise Palin is going to lead us in the invocational prayer. Then we'll have a choral selection. You got your hymn books this morning? All right, get your hymn books. Hymn number 477 be coming up, and then we'll do hymn number 234. And before it's all over, we'll do hymn number 190. How many of y'all from the old Baptist church when we used to have all this written down on the front of the church on the little board down front? Hymn number 477, amen, Deacon Palin. And then we'll do hymn number 234 and hymn number 190. And who knows what the Spirit might invoke in us, amen. Come on, let's bow our head. Let's get excited, amen. Get all excited as she leads us in prayer on this Holy Communion Sunday this morning. Deacon Palin, amen.
Good morning. Good morning. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we come before you this morning just to say thank you. We thank you for your grace and your mercy, Lord. And we now enter into the presence, your presence, through worship and praise today.
Pray, pray.
We thank you for your son, Jesus, who died on the cross for our sins. And God, we are grateful for opportunities to serve and to be more like you.
Say so.
Thank you for your bountiful blessings that you have already supplied us.
That's right.
And at this time, I'm going to lift up our Book of Jubilee.
Yeah.
And the Sacred Urn.
That's right.
On it, Lord, the prayers answered one by one.
One by one.
They're still being worked out, oh Lord. Our urn has the prayer requests and the petitions asking for them to be lifted up to you, oh God. We pray for our First Lady, Reverend Wanda Golden, Keep her safe in your arms. Give her the strength she needs to lead our ladies and form a bond more powerful than ever to fight the devil and all the things that are evil. We're praying for our Reverend Johnny Golden Sr., pastor of New Unity Baptist Church. We lift up his name and his words and his deeds.
Hallelujah.
Keep him in your loving arms and give him the power to move the church to greater heights.
Lord, grant it.
We claim victory now.
Pray.
Move, mountain.
Move, mountain.
God, we ask that you help us in our tithes and offerings, that we're giving it willingly, regularly, freely, and cheerfully.
Pray, Deacon.
He that soweth sparingly shall reap sparingly. Yeah. And he that soweth bountifully shall reap bountifully.
Pray.
Move, mountain. Thank you, Lord, for healing and deliverance. Our faith is stronger than ever because we believe your word and trust in you. We're praying for the world and our leaders. Cleanse their hearts, take away the negative things, and keep the country safe and protected, oh Lord. We're praying for our city, government, and communities and families, oh Lord, as we bond together. We're praying for the people in Ukraine, oh Lord, that there'll be peace in the land. Move, mountain. We lift up our youth and young adults, oh God. We pray for strong faith and protecting them as we nurture them and teach them how to become disciples for you. Move, mountain. In the precious name of Jesus, amen.
Core ministry, amen, amen, and amen.
Oh, count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your blessings, see what God has done. Count your blessings, name them one by one. Count your many blessings, see what God has done. You have your hymn book? Come on, turn with me now to hymn number 477. Amen. As we sing our Negro National Anthem, amen. Lift every voice and sing till earth and heaven ring. Ring with a harmony. Come on, everybody, as we ring it out this morning. Amen. Yeah. Yeah. Sing it. Sing, Brother Dixon. We have come over a way. With the tears that have been watered, we have come treading our path through the blood of the slaughtered. Out of the gloomy past, till we now stand at last where the white gleam of our bright star is cast. God, about where he is. Mama. Come light. Let us into the light. Keep us forever in the path. We pray, lest our feet stray from the place. Lest where we met thee, lest our hearts God be praised. Thank you so very much to both mother and son. Amen. As we bless the Lord here this morning. Amen. In the Dixon family. Amen. We're getting ready to prepare now to share the litany and the proclamation and the word of God. You have your placards. Amen. We mail them out to you. We sent them to you. Go find it, won't you? Look on the dining room table. There it is, right behind you, right behind the salt shaker. There it is. See it? Uh-huh. That's the one. It's in a little thing here. Laminated, that's right. I couldn't think of it. It's laminated for you, so it protects you if some coffee or some tea falls on it, right? And located, amen, and you'll find the scripture of the year and the proclamation there. Deacon Vanessa Thomas is going to come and share with us, and then following Deacon Thomas, Deacon Francis Jackson is going to come share with us the word of God found in the gospel according to St. John chapter 6, amen, verses 26 through 37. You ready? Come on, let's begin. Everybody, amen. Get all excited this morning. Amen. Counting your blessings this morning, looking unto Jesus. All right, we're ready, Deacon Thomas. God be praised.
Scripture of the year and litany. Fulfilling the mandate, the unseen and the unheard revealed to the people of God, great destinations beyond the veil. But as is written, eyes have not seen, nor ears heard, neither have entered into the hearts of man the things which God has prepared for them that love him.
Yeah.
But God hath revealed unto us by his Spirit. The Spirit searches all things, the deep things of God. For who have known the mind of the Lord,
who?
That he may instruct him?
Who taught
but God? We have the mind of Christ. 1 Corinthians chapter 2. Verses 9, 10, and 16. What day is this?
This is
the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord.
Yeah.
Our feet shall stand within thy gates, O Jerusalem. And the Lord answered me and said, write the vision and make it plain, that they may run that read it. For the vision is yet for an appointed time, but at the end it shall speak and not lie. Though it linger, wait for it, because it will surely come. For the just shall live by his faith.
Read.
For the Lord is in his holy temple. Let all the earth keep silence before him. And God made some apostles,
uh-huh,
and some prophets,
yeah,
and some evangelists,
yeah,
and some pastors, and some teachers, for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the kingdom, for the edifying of the body of Christ, until we all come into the unity of the faith and the knowledge of the Son of God, unto the fullness of Christ. Amen.
Amen, amen. I remain standing, won't you now, as Deacon Francis Jackson comes to lead us in the reading of the word. And I want you to read along with us, won't you? So we're going to give you a moment. Go locate your Bible, get your Bible wherever it is, amen. Open it up to the Gospel of St. John in the New Testament, Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, you remember it, amen. Flip over to the 6th chapter and let's read it together. Deacon Jackson, we're ready for you to lead us now.
Good morning. I'll be reading from the Gospel of St. John, chapter 6, verses 26 to 37. Again, that's the Gospel of St. John, chapter 6, verses 26 to 37.
Yeah.
It reads, Jesus answered them and said, most assuredly, I say to you, you seek me, not because you saw the signs, but because you ate of the loaves and were filled. Do not sorry, it's cutting off. Do not labor for the food which perishes, but for the food which endures to everlasting life.
That's it.
The Son of Man will give you, because God the Father has yet his seal on him. Then they said to him, what shall we do that we may work the works of God? Jesus answered and said to them, this is the work of God, that you believe in him whom he sent.
Yeah.
Therefore they said to him,
What sign
will you perform then that we may see it and believe you? What work will you do? Our fathers ate the manna in the desert, as mm-hmm. it is written. He gave them bread from heaven to eat. Then Jesus said to them, most assuredly, I say to you,
Moses
did not give you the bread from heaven, but my Father gives you the true bread from heaven.
Listen.
For the bread of God is he who comes down from heaven and gives life to the world. Then they said to him, Lord, give us this bread. And Jesus said to them, I'm sorry.
That's okay. I am. It's okay. Keep right on. I am
the bread of life.
Yeah.
He who comes to me shall never hunger.
Never hunger.
And he who believes in me shall never thirst. But I say to you that you have seen me and yet do not believe. Verse 7,
everybody.
All that the Father gives me will come to me, and the one who comes to me, I will by no means cast out. May God have a blessing to the reading and the hearing of his word. Amen.
Blessing on you, Deacon Jackson. So good to hear your voice, and we thank you so very much. Deacon Tamara Randolph comes now with our announcements and keeping us connected. Amen.
Amen, amen. Fulfilling the mandate, the unseen and the unheard revealed to the people of God. Great destination beyond the veil. Good blessed morning to our pastor and first lady, the Reverends Johnny and Wanda Golden Sr., and to all our New Unity Baptist Church family and friends. We welcome every guest and visitor sharing with us today. And a very special welcome to all sharing with us on our social media platforms, on Facebook, YouTube, and more. February has been our month of visioning all month long. We have been focusing on a shared vision for our future. As we close out the month of February, we are still standing firm in the faith and belief that without a vision, the people perish.
Mama.
It has been our history here at New Unity that during the month of February, we place emphasis on our Write the Vision month. And we write the vision and make it plain on tablets so he or she may run who reads it. We give honor to our Black history and rich heritage and share remarkable highlights throughout the month. Our leader, Deacon Sandra Jackson, and our youth and young adults have enlightened us each week, and we will hear from them again shortly. This March may not come in like a lion, at least not weather-wise for us. In fact, it's supposed to be gentle as a lamb. And since the weather is going to be simply beautiful this week, with spring already in the air, we have so many wonderful opportunities to get out and do greater ministry. Beginning with this Tuesday, March 1st, our You Matters Ministry Chat and Chew virtual gathering for family and friends 65 years old and older will gather at 1 p.m. For the month of March, they will meet twice, this Tuesday and again at the end of the month, Tuesday, March 29th. For further information, you may see the ministry leader, Deacon Marion High. On this Wednesday, March 2nd, we invite you to join us for our 12 noon hour of power to listen to a rebroadcast of a featured sermon. And then on that same day at the 7 p.m. hour, We encourage you to return that evening for our Ash Wednesday service, which for the Christian is the first day of Lent and begins the holy days of the Lenten Easter season. As we begin our season of penance, repentance, fasting, and prayer, we remind our members to please bring with you each week your blood droplets with your prayer petitions written on them. They were delivered to you last month, and if you did not receive yours, please reach out to our chair or vice chair, Deacons Hoover and Kearney, and they'll see that you get them. Pastor Golden and the leadership will give us further guidance and instruction on these and other upcoming Lenten services. This will all take place on our Zoom channel one. We continue to welcome you to join us on Saturday mornings for 1 hour of prayer with our Still Waters ministry from 7 to 8 a.m. on our Zoom One channel. And this is by audio only. Minister Catherine Giles and Sister Peggy Butler serves as the ministry leaders. Reminding all that our Christian education classes are held the first and third weekends of the month. Classes will resume this Saturday and Sunday, March 5th and 6th, and we have amazing classes for all ages, from primary through adults. Our youth and young adult classes takes place on Saturday, and our ministers and deacons leadership class and our Kairos Kingdom adult class takes place on Sunday mornings at 9 a.m. For further details, you may contact our Dean of Christian Education, Deacon Denise Palin. We remind you that you can get more information on these and other events going on at New Unity on our website at newunitybaptistchurch.org. New Unity Baptist Church, all spelled together, .org. Happy and blessed birthday to all our fabulous Februarians from your New Unity family. Let us prepare ourselves even now for the preached word. We have our Bibles, we have our pens, our journals, and we have a prayer in our hearts for the man of God as he comes with a transformative word from on high. Today's message is entitled, The Wow Factor. Amen and amen. Deacon Sandra Jackson, the platform is now yours.
Thank you, Deacon Randolph. Good morning, everyone. This is the last Sunday for Write the Vision Month and Black History Month, but that does not mean that we cannot keep writing the vision and that we cannot continue to celebrate Black health and wellness. Our presenter today is Brother Francis Dixon. He is the co-leader of our young adult ministry. He is the son of Brother Francis Dixon Sr. and Minister Annette Dixon. Brother Francis, the platform is yours.
Good morning, Pastor Golden, Reverend Wanda Golden, New Unity family and friends. There were many trailblazers in the medical and health field who broke barriers by making significant contributions and providing leadership that improved the health of millions and saved lives. They also fought slavery, prejudice, and injustice. So let's start with a first in history, Dr. James McCune Smith. Dr. Smith was an American physician, pharmacist, abolitionist, and author who was born into slavery in 1813 in Manhattan, New York. He was set free on July 4, 1827 at the age of 14. By the Emancipation Act of New York. In 1837, he became the first Black American to receive a medical degree at the University of Glasgow Medical School in Glasgow, Scotland. He applied to Columbia University at Geneva Medical College in New York State, but was denied admission due to racial discrimination. Dr. Smith was the first Black person to own and operate a pharmacy in the United States and the first Black physician to be published in U.S. medical journals. Dr. Smith was also well known for his leadership as an abolitionist and friend of Frederick Douglass. He contributed to Douglass's newspaper and wrote the introduction to his book, My Bondage and My Freedom. Frederick Douglass called Dr. Smith the single most important influence on his life. I have just read on Dr. McCune Smith. Thank you.
Beautiful.
Thank you, Brother Dixon. Now, Deacon Thomas, the platform is yours.
Good morning, New Unity family and visiting friends. It's giving time as we prepare now to give our gifts of our tithe and our offerings. We thank God for all of our faithful tithers. As the word declares in Luke 6:38, give and it shall be given unto you. Yeah. A good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over, will be poured into your lap. For with the same measure you use it, it will be measured to you. And we're so thankful for each and every one of you for your weekly financial support. So let's prepare now, New Unity, to give our two ways in which you can give is our Cash App, $ New Unity Baltimore, or you can mail in to P.O. Box 313, Chase, Maryland, 21027. Again, New Unity, we say may God continue to bless you in abundance. Now let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for all your loving kindness and grace towards us. Lord, we know that we can never begin to outgive you for all that you have provided to us. May we give our offerings to you today with gladness and joy. Everything we have belongs to you, and we rejoice to give some of your abundant gifts back to you. Bless the tithers, bless the offering as we give today through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Oh, bless the Lord, oh, my soul, New Unity, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. How many of y'all feel good this morning? I mean, you know, I don't mean fooling me. I mean, you feel good in your spirit. Amen. Amen. Deep down in my spot, I got the love of Jesus. When we'd holler out his children, where? Deep down in my soul, I got the love of, the sopranos would take us up, deep down in my soul, I got the love of Jesus. How many of y'all feel good in your soul this morning? Amen. I'm talking about old time church. Amen. Good church. Amen. Hallelujah. We bless the Lord. Amen. So glad again to see every one of you all in our places with bright sunshiny faces. Good morning to you. Good morning to you. Amen. We're coming up on the Lenten season. Amen. Beginning on this Tuesday, I mean, this Wednesday rather, Tuesday, what we call Fat Tuesday. But Wednesday is the first day of Lent, as Deacon Tamara Randolph has already reminded us. Amen. And so we'll be here. How many of you have your blood droplets? I want you to locate them if you would. Amen. Find them and bring them with you on Wednesday night, that you can write down your prayer petitions starting this Wednesday over the next 7 weeks. Each week we'll hear from, on Sunday morning, we'll hear from Minister Catherine Culver. She'll say a word to us about prayer and fasting, just a 1 minute word. Starting this week, Pastor Golden is giving you the scripture, Isaiah 53. Write it down if you would, please. Isaiah 53, verses 1 through 12, which is the entire chapter. We'll read Isaiah 53. Who hath believed our report? And to whom is the arm of the Lord revealed? We'll read that. And she'll say a word about the power of prayer and the power of fasting. Amen. Every week, just a 1 minute reminder to you and to me of what prayer does, what reading the scripture does, and what fasting does. This kind, Jesus says, cometh not out but by what? Prayer and fasting. And so we're going to be praying every Wednesday. We're praying every day, but we're going to be fasting every Wednesday. We'll say more about that this Wednesday, about exactly what we want you to do. We're suggesting and recommending that you do. Amen. As we join in this week and we are praying, amen. How many need a healing in your body? Amen. I need my mind. How many need a healing in your spirit? Amen. If you need one, raise your hand. Amen. How many need a healing? Healing. Amen. However you need it. Amen. We're going to be praying for healing of the body, of the soul, of the mind, of the spirit. Amen. We're believing that God's going to do it. Somebody say amen, that God's going to do it. God is going to do it. And how many had a chance to visit our website and hear Brother James Jones sing that song? If you haven't had a chance, go to the website and listen to him. But he said, and I still got a praise inside of me. Go to the website and hear Brother Jones and the men singing that. It'll bless you. It'll bless your spirit. Amen. But we're expecting great things. You hear the music playing there in the background. Amen. Just pull it down just a little bit. Amen. We're expecting great things. Great things. Great things. Great things. Somebody put it in the chat. Somebody just put it in the chat. Great things. Come on. Put it in there. Great things. Come on. Join in this worship. Just pull it down just a little bit if you would. Great things. Great things. We're expecting. Amen. From God. Great things. Amen. Say it. Come on, everybody. You can put it in there. Just put it in there. I'm expecting some great things from the Lord. Indeed, amen. You expecting, I declare, they're coming your way. You're coming your way. They're coming your way. Get ready for this. Get ready for this. This Wednesday, we begin with our Lenten season. Amen. We begin with our Lenten season as we lift up the name of the Lord. As we remember, this is Passion Week. We'll be entering in, right? Passion Week. Amen. And we bless the Lord. For that, I want to thank each of you who already been praying for Pastor Golden. Thank you for your prayer, even in the invocation, Deacon Palin, this morning. Amen. I had some surgery on this left eye this week, and it's coming along. It still needs by another month of healing. My eyes are slow healing. I had surgery on the right eye about a year and a half ago, and that took several months to heal. And so I suspect I'll have the same or similar process this year and with this left eye. But thank you for your prayers this week, and we'll be praying for many others. Even this morning, we're going to have who's our prayer? Minister Catherine Giles is going to be praying for all of us in our faith prayer. I want you to also pray for the people of Ukraine this morning. Amen. We have that war, that invasion, that turmoil over there that could easily spawn into some worldwide conflict. It really is, really could. I studied World War II when I was in school, and you would know this already, that all the events that ever happened in the world, everything that ever happened, the number one event that we have more footage on, more pictures on, is World War II. We got more footage on World War II. Just pull that music down just a little bit, MPM, if you could, please. We have this great footage on World War II, and so we're looking forward to praying for the people of God in the Ukraine, amen, so that we will not find ourselves in this war. It's a terrible situation. We need to stand with the people, I believe, amen. Also, I'm going to ask you to pray this morning. How many have been reading this week in the paper about Miss Ketanji Brown, amen. She's the new African-American jurist judge who's been nominated by President Biden to sit on the Supreme Court. Now, she's going to have a terrible uphill fight. Hear me now. It's going to be bruising. It will not be an easy confirmation. It will not be an easy confirmation. This woman is going to have to fight every day she goes before that Senate confirmation hearing, and they're going to try to destroy her, literally. Amen. And so we want to pray for Miss Ketanji Brown. She's a very educated, very intelligent, very sophisticated young lady. But the Republicans and senators have already made it known that they are coming out with a force against her sitting on the Supreme Court. We want to pray for her this morning. Amen. Absolutely. Amen. So as Deacon and Minister Giles prepares to pray, you prepare to pray. Amen. Certainly want to remember every one of you, all of our seniors, those of you who've been in the hospital or in the hospital, You may be listening in the hospital room even now or whatever, or preparing to go in, whatever the case is. Amen. We're going to be praying for you as Minister Catherine Giles prepares to pray. And as she prays, you pray with her. Amen. You pray with her because we serve a God that can do exceedingly abundantly above everything that you and I can ask or think. We're praying the prayer of faith. That F stands for faith. The A stands for adoration. The I stands for intercession. The T is thanksgiving. And the H has a double meaning, amen, is health and healing. And we're believing, as Minister Giles prayed this morning, amen, that we will receive, amen, the very petition that we have asked of the Lord. You bow your heads now, join in with us, amen, as she prays. Minister Giles, we're ready, amen, as we receive the prayer, amen, from the Lord. You got to unmute, leader. Amen, you have to unmute.
Amen, amen, amen. And may God's holy word live in us as we walk this faith journey this day. Father God, we thank you for being with us as we continue this journey of faith right now, Father. And we ask right now, Father God, as we continue to read your daily word, Father, that you know that we know that you are God to see all things and know all things, and that you walk this earth, Father God, and that you are helping those that call out the name of Jesus. And so as I read the words coming out of Hebrews 4, verses 12, the word of God is quicker and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing to the dividing under as under of soul and spirit, and of joint and marrow, and is discerning of thoughts and intentions of the heart. Neither is there any creature that is not manifest in his sight, but all things are naked and open until the eyes of him we have to do. Seeing then that we have a great high priest that is passed unto the heaven, Jesus, the Son of God, let us hold fast our profession, our possession. For we have not a high priest which cannot be touched with the feeling of our infirmity, but within all points appointed like as we are, yet without sin. Let us therefore come boldly unto the throne of grace, that we may attain mercy and find grace to help in a time of need. Father God, we know that we serve an awesome God and an awesome priest, Jesus the Christ. And as we continue this faith journey, Father God, we thank you for the daily bread that you have given us. We thank you for the healing and the touching of those who call upon your name and believe in your faith and believe in your words. This I pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. And the church again says amen.
Amen.
Amen. All right, Minister Giles, we thank you so very much this morning. Brother Dixon's going to come now and share with us in the word of God and music. Amen. Then we come with a gospel message this morning. Our message entitled this morning, The Wow, W-O-W, The Wow Factor, The Wow Factor. Amen. Brother Dixon.
From the highest of heights to the depths of the sea, creations revealing your majesty. From the colors of fall to the fragrance of spring, every creature unique in the songs they sing, indescribable, uncontainable. You place the stars in the sky and you know them by name. You are amazing, God, all powerful, untamable, awestruck we fall to our knees and we humbly proclaim, you are amazing, God. Who told every lightning bolt where to go? Seen heavenly storehouses laden with snow. Who imagined the sun up and gave source to its light? Conceals it to bring us the coolest of night. None can fathom indescribable, uncontainable. You place the stars in the sky and you know them by name. You are amazing, God. All powerful, untamable, all struck we fall to our knees as we humbly proclaim, you are amazing, God. Indescribable, uncontainable, you place the stars in the sky and you know them by name. You are amazing, God. Incomparable, unchangeable, you see the depths of my heart and you love me the same. You are amazing, God. Oh, you are amazing, God. Oh, you are amazing, God.
Amen, amen. Thank you so very much, Brother Dixon. Amen. Just one of the many, many words that we could use, amen, to define this awesome God whom we love and whom we serve. Amazing, amen, amazing. Among a million others, amen. Of over 4,000 tongues to sing my great Redeemer's praise. Again, we welcome you here on this last Sunday in the month of February to all of our February celebrants who are having birthdays this month. Again, we salute you. In particular, permit me to lift up my sisters, Sister Vanessa and my sister Charlene Barnes. Now that means all of you, of course, who celebrate this month at pastor and church, lift you all up. But I want to give a special shout out to my two sisters this morning. God be praised to them and to you. Amen. If God favored you to be born in this second month of the year, amen. Give God all the praise and glory and thanksgiving for the great thing that he has done and continues to do. I wanted to show you this morning because I trust and pray that you have yours. Amen. This envelope that the church sent you, and inside of that, you're going to find your red droplet located. Now you know what. Now you say, I got one of these. I didn't know what this thing was for. And we're going to be using that starting this Wednesday, which is Ash Wednesday, the first day of Lent. Amen. And so we're asking you to locate the envelope. Amen. Bring it with you on this Wednesday. Pastor Golden will be preaching and teaching this Wednesday. Then we have Minister Giles and Minister Smith and Minister Sister Pentecost Dixon, all following in their particular weeks, amen, sharing every Wednesday as we lifting up the word of God, talking about Lent, talking about this passion, talking about our Savior who gave his life, amen, for you and I. And we're going to be reading beginning on this week, Isaiah 53, amen, who hath believed our report, and to who is the arm of the Lord revealed, talking about this suffering servant. That's what it's all. A piece of scripture, a portion of scripture that talks about the suffering servant who is to come, this Messiah, this suffering servant, this Christ who will come. And so you bring your blood droplet with you on this Wednesday and each Wednesday thereafter. Amen. We ask you to support the church in a special donation every week. Amen. Every week with a special donation just for Lenten, not talking about your tithe and offering now, just during this Lenten season as we prepare to come to the Lord. Thanking him for giving his life for you and for me. Amen. I want to thank all of those who journeyed with Pastor on yesterday, traveled over to the facility over on the west side of town, 800 North Carrollton Street. Thank you so very much for your presence and for your witness. Amen, amen, and amen again. You have your Bibles with you this morning. I want to invite you to turn in your Bibles as we look to the Word of God out of the book of the book of John. Amen. So look in the book of John, won't you now, please? John chapter 6, all over the church. Amen. Everyone share there, won't you please? Amen. Kennedy, find a caller, call Kennedy. All right, pardon me for that little interlude. I had a, amen. We do bless the Lord, amen, for that, amen. Come down to verse 26 there, if you would lead us, amen. Verse 26, won't you please? Amen. And Jesus answered them and said, verily, verily, I say unto you, seek me not because you saw the miracles, but because you did eat the loaves and were filled. Now come down to 46, if you would, please. I'm saying that on the screen for those of you on the phone. I'm reading for what's on the monitor. Not that any man have seen the Father, save he which is of God, have seen the Father. Verily I say unto you, he that believeth on me hath everlasting life. I am the bread of life. Your fathers did eat manna in the wilderness and are dead. This is the bread which cometh down from heaven, that a man may eat thereof and not die. Jesus speaking now, I am the living bread which came down from heaven. If any man eat of this bread, he shall live forever. And the bread that I will give is my flesh, which I give for the life of the world. The Jews therefore strove among themselves, saying, how can this man give us his flesh to eat? Then Jesus said unto them, verily, verily, I say unto you, except you eat the flesh of the Son of God and drink of his blood, you have no life in you. Whosoever eateth my flesh and drinketh my blood hath eternal life, and I will raise him up at the last day. For my flesh is meat indeed, and my blood is drink indeed. He that eateth my flesh and drinketh my blood dwelleth in me, and I in him. As the living Father hath sent me, amen, and I live by the Father, so he that eateth me, even shall he live by me. This is the bread which came down from heaven. Not as your fathers did eat manna and are dead, he that eateth of this bread shall live forever. Amen. The word of God indeed for the people of God. I want to take a moment, even in this moment, as we are preparing to share the word. Let me pause for a moment, salute you, Brother Aaron Jiggers, and all of our wonderful MTE ministry. Bless the Lord for every one of you young persons and others who are getting up early in the morning. Brother Aaron, for the past 2 weeks, been getting up early, getting dressed, driving from the eastern side of Baltimore County all the way to the western side, amen, that he can get better training, further training of how to use the cameras and the microphones and the various instruments of our Zoom encounter week after week. Thank you so very much. And if you see something or hear something that is not quite as clear and as sharp as you were, as it had been, I want to thank you now for your patience and understanding that we've got a trainee. He's in his apprenticeship, shall we say, amen, and he's learning. And so if the microphone goes silent or the video goes whatever, mine went silent a moment ago. That was on my end. My granddaughter was calling me out of the blue. I was wondering who in the world calling me on a Sunday morning here, knowing I'm in church with one of my granddaughters. And so I had to respond to that, thought that she was in distress, but all is well. Amen. But that was done by Pastor Golden. So we thank the Lord for you, Brother Aaron and Brother Tyler and Sister Andrea, and on and on and on, all of you, Sister Kiana, and others who will be added to the ministry in due course of time. Thank you, Brother Aaron, for what you're doing, and others week after week, helping to grow our ministry and make it premier in every aspect of its production, every aspect of its presentation. Amen. Let the people of God indeed together say amen, amen, and amen. As I prepare, may I say again, we are the equipping ministry, empowering the people of God for the work of the kingdom. It is through our prophetic ministry of, say it with me, these four P's. Come on, say it with me. Prayer. Somebody say prayer. Prayer. Preaching. That's what we're getting ready to do now. Preaching. Praise. Come on. Praise. And pedagogy, which is teaching, that we, the New Unity Baptist Church, seek to do the work of the kingdom. Amen and amen and amen again. As I prepare for this final Sunday of Black History Month and celebration, I want to pause going into this as we are preparing to end this month. Take a moment and salute those griots, G-R-I-O-T, those griots and ancestors of yesteryear, particularly our great worship leaders and singers who led us in song as we entered into the sacred space. Was not always a building, a brick and mortar, or wood and stone. Sometime it was in the early days down by the bulrushes, down by the harbor, as it were. Not the inner harbor of Baltimore, but as they hid away and they would go down there to the water, take thick, heavy blankets with them, dip them in the water and hang them on the bushes so that the sound of their voices as they sang and worshiped, prayed and cried, their voices would be caught in the wet blanket and they would be muted and would not travel back up to the big house so that the master could hear them as they prayed and worshiped the Lord. I want to take a moment to salute those persons, sainted persons, as they reminded us of the fact that we did not come to America to discover God, but even in the motherland, we knew that there was a God somewhere. We did not sing the songs that we sing today necessarily, but we knew and understood, over my head, I hear music in the air. There must be a God somewhere. It is my prayer, my hope, New Unity, to all of you ministers, to all of you deacons, to all of our youth, to all of our seniors, to all of our newly married, all of our betrothed, all of those fiancés, all of those who are visiting for the first time or the 99th time. It is my sincere prayer that we as a people will never forget the long road from whence we have come and the even longer road that lies ahead. Somebody ought to say, amen. It is my prayer, brothers and sisters, that even though I personally am okay, and that is the word I will use, I won't say satisfied, glad, or happy, but Sister Tanya, I'll say I'm okay with some of the gospel music or the word or the music that is purported to be gospel in this present age. I trust and pray. It is my heartfelt responsibility and task to remind New Unity from whence we have come, and that I will do all that I can, Brother Williams, to help us neither forget nor abandon our sacred and sainted past. The songs of Zion that we sing, thank God for the praise songs of the day. The song that we lift up the voice, our voices, and give God honor and praise and thanksgiving, thank God for the worship songs of today. But I pray that we shall never, ever forget the songs of yesteryear. What are they doing in heaven today? I pray that we shall never forget the songs of yesteryear, where the Lord has brought us from a mighty long way. If we sing hymn number 477, that sing the lift up your voice and sing the Negro National Anthem, surely then hymn number 190 is our Star Spangled Banner. And I do understand that the Star Spangled Banner and the National Anthem are the same thing, but if 477 is our National Anthem, then 190 surely would have to be our Star Spangled Banner as we hear our mothers and fathers of yesterday sing, charge to keep, I have a God to glorify. Another dying soul to save and fit it for the sky. We'd hear the preacher, the song leader, leading out those songs, Deacon Vanessa Thomas, at the people. They didn't sing in verse. They led it, Brother Randolph, they led in what we call meter. It was common meter. And the preacher or the song leader would lead out, Brother John, on me with jealous care, as in thy sight to live. And then the people will come, on me. And you can hear the old folk, and they didn't use the music of the day, but it was common meter. I pray to God that we will never forget the common meter of yesteryear. I pray to God that that at least during Pastor Golden's tenure, that somebody down the road, some young person would say, there was a preacher when I was a little girl, or there was a preacher when I was a little boy that led us, and my mothers and fathers talked about him, came up from Greenville, South Carolina in the early 1960s, during the great migration of Black people leaving the South and coming to the North and the West. You ought to know your history, and I'm proud of it. I don't care what anybody say. I know they don't want me to talk about race, and they don't want to talk about critical race theory. It's okay on the 17th of next month, somebody wake up and hear me, for everybody to go to the pub and drink green beer. Y'all don't want me to talk. It's all right for them to decorate the whole city with leprechauns and four-leaf clovers. Don't get mad with me. I'm just telling you what's going on. It's okay for the Jews to talk about Purim. It's okay on October the 12th for everybody of Italian ancestry and heritage to lift up Mr. Columbus, Christopher Columbus. It's all right. We got a highway leading right here in Baltimore called Pulaski Highway. The Polish can lift up General Pulaski. If you go downtown to the Inner Harbor, they got a big old gold statue of General Pulaski in front of the Marriott Hotel downtown. But when it comes to Black history, everybody turns their nose and don't want me to talk about it. But God's, I'm telling, shame on you. As long as I'm pastor here, as long as God gives me breath, that you Black, white, green, or brown, it does not matter. I'm going to lift up the fact that God's been good to me and God made me. And if you don't think I'm beautiful, I do. I don't care what you think about my ego. I don't care what you think about my mindset, my nappy hair, my thick lips, my big. I'm going to bless the Lord, oh, my soul and all that is within me, because God's been good to me. And when God made me, you got to say your own amen. God was at his absolute best when God created me. I am a designer original. Don't need no Gucci on me. Don't need no LV, no Louis Vuitton. My name is Johnny Napoleon Golden. I am who I am, and I'm grateful and proud of it. Somebody, you got to say your own amen, my brothers and sisters. So I pray that on this fourth Sunday, on this last Sunday, when we lift up our grandmothers that came to church in house coats and did not have fur coats like we have, that we would still remember them, those people who suffered for us, that we could go to school and go to college and get an education, those who sacrificed for us, could not read and write the same degree that we had, but they had a sense of knowing that if God be for you, somebody say amen. Who in the world can be against? I wish somebody would look at me and say amen and get rid of them frowns on your faces. Amen. Don't get mad because I'm talking about what God has done for us as a people. Our mothers and fathers of yesteryear, they had their chants. And one of the reasons those chants, as they prayed, Deacon Marion High, and one of the reasons that they had those chants there, Deacon Denise Palin, they were so popular in times past because they reminded us and reminded them of our difficult past. But as difficult as it were, they were able to come to worship service. Somebody say priest, pastor. They were able to come to worship service, lift up their hands and say, thus far has the Lord helped us. Even though they bore the burden in the heat of the day, even though in Sister Nita Lassiter, they went through whips and went through slaps and knocked down, they still were able to say, here I raise my Ebenezer. They came to worship Brother Kearney, and they said, oh, my brothers and sisters, not at the pub, not at the club, not at the end of a pipe, not at the end of some jewel, not at the end of a glass or whatever, but they said, here I bring my wounded heart, here bring your wounded heart, here bring your anguish. Earth has no sorrow that heaven, come on here, cannot heal. Somebody say, priest, pastor. Well, I want to remind you of the spirituals, brother Francis Dixon, that we learned in years gone by. And I hope that we will, every February of every year, take the time out to sing three or four spirituals, amen, to remind the youth, to remind all of us, amen, of the bridge that got us over. Somebody say, amen, the bridge, Sister Angela Carter, that got you over, amen. I hear Mahalia Jackson sing, how I got over, how I got over. My soul looks back and wonder how I got over, knowing that through many dangers, toils, and snares, I feel power here. I already come towards grace that brought me thus far, and grace shall lead me on. And whether you hear, my brothers and sisters, the sacred spirituals of the church, listen to me now, or whether you hear the music, amen, of our people, listen to the music that I share with you this morning. These tinnitus, you hear the cruel chains, the sound of the chains of the men and women, these Africans, as they were tethered and tied together to their misery. Listen, coming out of New Orleans, Louisiana, 1901, here is Louis Armstrong, Satchmo, got his horn, and he's blowing. You can hear him blow, coming out. And then 10 years later, my God, Sister Kiba, 10 years later, 1911, here comes Mahalia Jackson, born in the same city. Y'all don't want me to preach. Born in the same community. Come on, Satchmo blowing on his horn in 1901, he's born. 10 years later, come 1911, here comes Mahalia Jackson, and yet both of them lifting up their voices and reminding us of where we have been from. Listen, if you will. How many of y'all have ever heard of the Gullah Singers? The G-U-L-L-A-H. The Gullah Singers are down there off of the coast of South Carolina and off of the coast of Georgia and off of the coast of Florida. They live on the islands down there. These are Black people who come from Africa like you and I who live down there. They are called the Gullah Singers, and they sing these old songs, and they remind us also, distinctive as it is, of who we are and what God has done for us. But listen, if you will, somebody say, listen up, sisters. Listen up, brothers. How many of y'all have heard of a man by the name of Sam Cooke? Sam Cooke used to sing his song, and most of us are familiar with A Change Is Gonna Come, aren't you? But Sam Cooke, listen to the song now. Listen to the song. He said, that's the sound of the men working on the chain. Gang, that's the sound of the men working on the chain. Gang, all day long they work so hard. Now that is Sam Cooke, but there's a part of it that is very what shall we say, important, that I left out. And most people probably did not pick it up unless you are a music aficionado or a music critic. And that is, in the background while Sam is singing, every other line you hear the word "huh." That's the sound of the men, huh. Now, what that huh is, brothers and sisters, hear me, Mother Virginia Woodley, you would know this, 95 years young and blessed as you are. This huh is the sound of the slaves as they were going down planting the pods of seeds in the field, whether it was tobacco or cotton or whatever it were, right? As they dropped the pod in there, they had the music going as they were singing, and the huh said, drop your pod, and now step forward another 30 inches and drop another one in, huh, and they drop another one in, huh, and they drop another one. Sam Cooke was reminding us that when the slaves were hooked together, brothers and sisters, the huh was the sound of them dropping, so they all moved together in concert. And he was reminding us that even though the men were chained by the legs and their leg irons, that as they moved, they all had to move in concert with one another. It would be difficult if one man was standing still and the next man was trying to move. And so the "huh," Sister Vanessa Thomas, was a sound, a signal to give you, to let the next person know it's time to move. How many of y'all know this to be a fact? Let me see your hand. That whenever God gets ready to move, he always sends a signal first. Y'all ain't helping me here. I said, whenever the Lord, come on, somebody help me preach here. I just want to talk to the people who are going to help me preach this morning. Whenever the Lord, I see you, Sister Dixon. I hear you, Sister Arlene. Whenever the Lord gets ready to move, he always sends a signal. He lets you know what's going on. How many of y'all in tune with God? Come on here. How many in tune? How many trying to get yourself in tune with the Lord? Sometimes to get out of tune, don't we? But hallelujah, like a piano, you know, you got to bring the person in there and she got to sit down and hit that C and hit that F and get it all tuned up. And every now and then, the things of this life will cause you and I to get out of tune with God. But my brothers and sisters, keep on striving. Keep on trying, my brothers and sisters, to get in tune with God. Hear our mothers and fathers say, "Guide me, O thou great Jehovah." That's hymn number 34, 234, by the way, in your hymn book. "Guide me, O thou great Jehovah. Lead me on, Lord, through this pilgrim land. I am weak, but thou art mighty. Hold me with thy powerful hand." And then they sing, and you can hear the drum, boom. Can't you just see them? Boom, 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 boom. They didn't come like trying to be all pretty. Didn't have all the fancy things. They just came just as they were to worship God. And I want to tell somebody this morning, when you come to church, come just as you are. Just open up your heart. Say, "Lord, here I am. Got some stuff in me that I know ain't right. Got some stuff, Lord, that I'm not even happy about. But Lord, here I am, just as I am, without one plea. I'm giving it all to the Lord." Somebody say, "Lord, I'm turning it all over to you." Amen. Everything. Come on here. I'm turning everything over to you. Oh, bless the Lord. Don't try to hide it. God knows all about us, don't he? He sees in the dark the way you and I can see sometimes in the light. "Guide me, O thou great Jehovah." And then we sing that next line. Bread of heaven, feed me till I want no more." Now, let me move real quickly into this message further as we prepare to come to the table on this Holy Communion Sunday. And then I see a bunch of folk on the screen by name and number that I don't know. And I suppose they came here to shake Sister Kiba's hand. And I want to hear from them. I want to know who they are. They all shaking their head already. Yeah, they smiling already, saying, "Yeah, Reverend, we here because Nakiba done called us and told us I'm getting the right hand of fellowship. And one of them might join. Who knows? The Holy Ghost can move while you out there shaking hand." Somebody say, "Why are you trying to figure it out? God's done already what? Worked it out. Why are you trying to understand? What is Reverend Golden talking about? That's a man. That man sure is something else, Keeper. Why didn't you tell me about him sooner than this?" But I want you to know, why are you and I trying to figure it out? God has already worked it out. In our text this morning, Jesus talks about the fact that he is the bread of life. Come on here, Golden. Go back with me just for about a minute, if you will. Church, here is in the book of Samuel, a man by the name of David. David's being chased by a man by the name of King Saul. David's been anointed king, but he has not been coronated yet. He's on his way up. He's ascendant, but he has not gotten there yet. And somebody write it down. I know God has blessed me. Come on, write it down in your own journal. Write it down. I know that God has blessed me. I know that God has called me. I'm on my way up. Come on, write it down. But I still got some things I got to go through before I'm crowned. What I got to go through, Pastor Golden? There are three things you got to go through. You got to understand here. One, that you don't get there to the top overnight. It's progressive. Come on, write it down. Say, my ascendancy, my exaltation, my climb to the height is not overnight. It is progressive. Secondly, when I'm going through a difficult time and I don't know how I'm going to make it, write it down, church. Just write it down. Provision. The Lord will make a way somehow. And thirdly, when I get distressed and when I get all flustered and when I get all mad and want to quit, then I got to remember the promise. It's progressive, it's provision, and it's promise. It's promise, it's provision, and it's progress. What are you saying, Pastor? David went to the tabernacle. He said, I'm being chased. I ain't got no food. I ain't got no money, but y'all got anything in here that can feed me? They said, we don't have anything here in this tabernacle that can feed. He said, what's that over there on the table? They say, that's the showbread. That belongs to the priest. You got two stacks of it. You got one stack with six loaves in it. You got another stack with another six in it. That's 12 loaves of bread. Those 12 loaves of bread represent the 12 tribes of Israel. Those two stacks represents the two tablets of stone that Moses received the 10 commandments on. And that's only for the priest to be eaten on the Sabbath day as they put out fresh bread. David said, give it to me. They said, wait a minute now. You can't get this. You ain't no priest. David said, give it to me. They said, no, you can't hand this. He said, give it to me. He asked them, and they told him the third time, all right, we're going to give it to you. We've been moved. If the men have kept themselves clean, if the men have kept themselves unspotted and honorable, we'll give you this bread. Somebody see that he didn't get it the first time. Come on, that's progressive. Didn't get it the second time. I'm talking about progressive. You don't always get everything you want in life the first time. Somebody say, priest, Pastor, you got to go back again, and sometimes you got to go back again, and sometimes you got to go back again and again. That's progressive. But if you keep on hanging in there, though you don't have what you need and you don't have what you want, the Lord will provide. Somebody say it right now. The Lord will provide. He'll help you with whatever you're going through. Somebody say, the Lord, thus far hath the Lord helped me. And David was able to get the bread. And to go out and share it with the men who are traveling with him because the Lord had blessed him. Now, let me come forward a little bit as we try to hurry to our end. There was a woman in the book of Matthew, there it is, and in the gospel according to Luke, Luke says she was a Canaanite woman. No, Matthew says she was a Canaanite woman. Mark says she was a Greek woman, a Syrophoenician woman. And he says, a Canaanite woman. She came, she heard that Jesus was in her town. And so she came to him and said, look at this. She says, son of David, have mercy on me. My daughter is sick. She's real sick. She got all kinds of situations going on. But I believe if you would touch her, my daughter would be made whole. Now, look at this. This woman is not a Jew. She's not part of the covenant. She's outside of the daughters of Sarah. She's not one of Sarah's daughters. She's a Gentile, if you will. But she came to Jesus, this Canaanite woman. Come on, Golden. This Syrophoenician woman, this dark-skinned woman came to Jesus and said, if you can just touch my daughter, I know she'll be all right. Look at what Jesus said to her. Anybody going to help me here? Jesus said, I'd like to help you, sister, but what I got is not for the dogs. It is for the children of God. Y'all ain't hear me. Look at the text. The text said that Jesus told her, you are a dog, and what I got is not for the dogs, but it's for the children of God. She turned around. Now, whenever somebody slams you, come on here. Whenever somebody slams you high, this is what you got. You got a choice which way you're going to go. Somebody write it down. Say, whenever the devil comes up against me, how will I respond? I can knock the devil out. Come on here, LL Cool J. Mama say, knock you out. Or I can say, I'm going to knock you out with prayer. Which way I'm going to go with this thing? And so she's at a point now. She can humble herself and say, wait a minute, or she can get filled with hubris. She can go H-U-M, humble, or she can go H-U-B, hubris, full of pride. But she decides, I need something from the Lord. And whenever you need something for the Lord, don't be ashamed, church, to humble yourself. Come on here. Don't be afraid to say, Father, I need, my daughter is sick. Father, my boyfriend, my girlfriend, my mother, my father, my sister, my brother. Lord, we're standing in the need of prayer. Somebody's got COVID. Somebody's sick. Somebody's getting ready to get an eviction. Somebody's in trouble. And so, Lord, we just come in and say, we need you today. Somebody say, yes, Lord. Anybody need the Lord today? Anybody need the Lord today? Say, Lord, we need you today. She said, now, listen to this. What would you say, church? Just think about it. If you came, say, Pastor Golden, I need for you and Reverend Wanda to lay hands on me. Anoint us with oil and pray for. And I said, I'd like to pray for you, but you're a dog. How would you, my God, what would you think about that? And Jesus told the woman, it's not meat that I should give the children's bread to the dogs. Look at this. But she said, yes, Lord, I know you're right about it. I know you're right about it. But even the dogs eat the crumbs from the master's table. Look at this. She didn't get mad. She didn't start putting her hand on her hip and let her backbone slip. She didn't wiggle her head. She just simply said, Master, I know you're right about it. But Lord, even the dogs, look, bottom mighty. She called her a dog. But she said, even the dogs eat the crumbs from the master's table. But she knew, Brother Derek, my God, you know what I'm getting ready to say, that everything that's in the loaf is in the crumb. Somebody write it down, that everything that's in the loaf, come on here, is in the crumb. Everything that's in the loaf is in the crumb. Now get this next line, Sister Inell Colvin. She read the Bible from Genesis to Revelation. Read the text. All you scholars, this is the only time in Scripture that you will hear Jesus say, my bad. When this woman came to Jesus and told him, my God, I know you're right about it, Lord, but even the dogs eat the crumbs from the master's table. Jesus said, my bad. Y'all ain't helping me. He gave this woman exactly what she asked for. And he said, I've never seen faith like this anywhere. Anybody need some bread from the Lord? Anybody needs, come on here. Anybody need to be fed from heaven? She said, I'm a dog. That's all right. But you got what I need. And he said, you're right about it. Because of your faith, your daughter is made whole. Somebody say, that's intercession. Let me wrap this thing up here, church, in the sixth chapter. John, as we finished reading just now, Jesus talks to the Jewish people of his day, and they are arguing with him. And he says, now, are you following me because you love me? Are you following me because you believe that I am the Son of God? Or you follow me simply because I was able to feed you in the earlier part of chapter 6 and give you bread and take the fish and the 5 loaves? Are you following me because you love me? Or you follow me because of the miracles? And he says, now listen here, I am the bread of life. In the book of John, there are 7 I ams. But he talks this one here right now. I am the bread of life. If any man eat of me, he shall not die and live. They say, wait a minute, who does he think he is? He says, now let me give you a little history lesson. And brothers and sisters, the way I started this message off is the way I want to end it. Remind you of your history. Jesus said, when your fathers and your mothers were in the desert, they were fed by bread that came down from heaven. But look at this. They said, that's right. We know our history. Black folk, you need to know your history. White folk, you need to know your history. Irish folk, you need to know what the Lord has done for you. Somebody ought to hear me this morning. And they say, yes, he fed us. Moses fed us with bread from heaven. And Jesus said to them, he said, you're right about it. You're right about it. But guess what? They ate that bread and they still died. Come on here. Oh, somebody said, you just rocked my world. He said, y'all ate bread from heaven and you still died. I got to let that sink in for a moment. He said, even though you did not go to the grocery store, did not go to Pantry Pride, did not go to Food Fair, did not go to Giant, did not go to Safeway, did not go to Smith's Blue Ribbon, did not go to Wholesome, did not go to Whole Foods, did not go to Hash Tweeter, but wherever you went and got your bread, the bread that you've been eating, you still died. Your fathers and mothers still die. Don't care how much it costs. Don't care if it was organic bread. Don't care if it was bread that was baked that cost $20 a slice, not just a loaf. They ate that bread and they still died. But he said, but if you eat of my bread, if you eat of this body, ye shall never die. I got to close by telling you, we're getting ready to go to the communion table in a moment. And Jesus said, unless you eat of my body, unless you drink of my blood, you shall not live. I want to tell somebody here this morning, the reason we come to the table, because he says, as oft as you do this, you do it in remembrance of me. And we're coming to identify with the church of Jesus Christ. Somebody say amen. If you can't make but one service a month, be sure you're at communion. Write it down. Pastor Golden said, if you can't make first Sunday, second, third, or fifth, be sure whatever month, whatever Sunday, the church serves Holy Communion. Might be the first Sunday, second, third, whatever it is. Be sure that you get there for Holy Communion, because that's the Sunday that you sit down at the table and you're able to eat and feed from the body of Christ. And none of us will die. Some glad morning, when this life is over, we're going to fly away. Yeah, we're going to leave here, New Unity. We're going to leave here and feast at the welcoming table. I heard Solomon when he said, he brought me to his banqueting table, and his banner over me is love. How many know that God is love? For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. Come on, say it with me. That whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. How many plan to go to heaven one day? How many plan to see the Lord one day? Somebody say, Pastor Golden, I got a mother in that land. Somebody say, I got a father in that land. Somebody say, I got a sister in that land. Somebody say, I got a brother in that land. And soon and very soon, we're going to see Jesus, church. Yes, we are. We're going to see Jesus one day. You're going to look around and the trump of the Lord, I'm clothing now, will sound. Somebody say, yeah, the trump of the Lord shall sound and the dead in Christ will rise. Somebody send a come on here. Somebody call up Dion Warwick and send a message to Michael. Tell Michael that when you tried to get the word down to Daniel that the Lord was on the way, Daniel withstood him. Well, the Satan rather withstood him, and Michael could not get the word down. But somebody say, hold up, Gabriel gonna blow his trumpet. It won't be long, and when the trump of the Lord shall sound, the dead in Christ shall rise, and we're going to see the Lord for ourselves and not another. I don't know about you, but I still, can I just close by telling you, I still say there was a preacher in Baltimore used to preach like I don't know what, couldn't understand half of what he said, but I remember this one. He told us, I still believe in heaven. Now, he told us he was an old time preacher. He wasn't living to get a Cadillac down here, but if you give him one, he'd use it. He wasn't living to get a Lexus down here, but if you gave him one, he'd use it. But he was going to another place. I got a home in glory on the other side. And he said he used to sing a song when he was a little boy. He said, I got a home in bright glory on the other side of Jordan. And one day, I don't know, I know y'all done got happy down here. And it's okay to be happy down here. Don't let nobody tell you. But I want you to know my true happiness is not down here on earth. I'm going to heaven one day. I'm going to heaven one day. When I go home to South Carolina, I try to always get down, go down Route 25, about 25 miles or so, and then you hook a left. Don't ask me. There ain't no road there. You just hook a left. You just have to know this is the place. You hook a left and go way back in the woods, not in a road, in the woods. And then you go back so far, and a little old sign in the ground, you can hardly read it, about 100 years old. It says the New Forkville Baptist Church. You hook that right and going down there, and then you'll come down to the church where my grandmother is buried, and my grandfather is buried, and my father is buried, and all the Goldens are buried down there. Well, I'm going to see them one day. Hallelujah. And when I go down to South Carolina, I always go to the, I know some of y'all think I'm crazy, but I go to the cemetery, and I talk to my grandmother, and I talk to my grandfather, and I talk to them old folk that I'm going on the glory. But I try never to go home without going to the cemetery and talking to them. And believe it or not, I listen to them. And when I get back to Baltimore, I got better sense. Y'all ain't helping me. I got better sense, Sister Sarah, by going home and listening to the saints of yesteryear than I had before I went down there. And one day we're going to see them again, church. This bread from heaven. This bread from heaven. I want y'all to know Jesus is the light and Jesus is the bread of heaven. And if you trust in him, you too can eat from this bread and never die. Somebody say amen this morning. Come on, somebody say amen. Come on, somebody say it again. Bread of heaven. Bread of heaven. Bread of heaven. Feed me till I want no more. Somebody, let me just close here as we open the doors of the church. Somebody might say, Pastor Golden, you said it was going to be about the wow factor. Mm-hmm. Well, the first wow, when David came, he was wondering why he couldn't get the bread, and it was an old wow. The second wow, when the woman asked him and Jesus called her a dog, it was the bow wow. Ah, somebody hear me this morning. The third wow, yes, Lord. The third wow, when he saw them bread, bread of heaven, it was a wow factor that no man can ever figure out what God going to do in your life. Don't ever think you got it all figured out. That's the wow that beyond our understanding, it is the aha moment of every true believer's life. And so as we bow our heads now to pray, Father, we thank you this morning. We thank you for the wow factor. From the bow wow to the old wow to the here and now wow. We thank you, O God, because you are an everlasting God. You were here. You carried our mothers, our fathers, our sisters, our brothers, our grandparents for years gone by. And Lord, you're carrying us through some deep waters right now. Our world is in an awful fix, but you're taking us, Lord, and we're grateful. Thank you, God, because you bless us in every dimension of our life. We thank you, God, because you're keeping our children safe from harm, safe from the bullets and the guns and all of the maddening stuff that goes on in our world. We surrender it all to you, God, and we thank you. Now I want to open up the doors of the church to you, my sister, to you, my brother. Wherever you are here in Baltimore, Atlanta, wherever you are, you might say, Pastor Golden, I want to know more about this God. I want to hear more about that preaching. I want to get a better understanding about this wow factor and this man named Jesus, this savior of the world. And all you have to do, my sister, all you have to do, my brother, say, Pastor, I want to join the church. I want to give my heart to God. I don't know what all that means. I know I'm supposed to. And I want you to know it's just the first step of many. I'm still climbing myself, brothers. I'm still climbing right now, brother. Every day I'm trying to get one step higher. Just one more. We are climbing Jacob's ladder. And every round taking us higher and higher. And so if you're here this morning, my sister, you're here today, my brother, and you say, Pastor Golden, I want to join New Unity. I want to become a member of the body of Christ. I want to be saved. All you have to do is raise your hand or hit the arrow button there or the reaction button, whatever it is, that we can see who you are. We'll announce you to the church. We'll receive you in with all joy and all thanksgiving to God. And we'll gladly go down this road together, marching up the King's Highway. And so we say, is there one this morning is there a man or a woman, boy or girl, family, the pastor, I'm here, and I want to join the church today. You might be on the phone and we can't see you. Well, we'll just somehow you get our attention. Don't you let this service close, amen. Just because you're on the phone, you make it some kind of way. If you got to call somebody, if you got to call me, my phone been ringing all morning. Call me, Pastor Golden. I'm calling you. Answer the phone, Pastor. Answer the phone. Answer the phone, Pastor Golden. That's me on the line, 410-302-0470. Call me now. You know, it's just tell my J.J. Winfrey, it's my salvation and I want it now. Y'all know that commercial, J.J. Winfrey say, it's my money and I want it now. Tell him, it's my happiness. It's my joy. It's my peace of mind, and I need it now, Pastor Golden. My phone rang this morning. I was in the bed phone. Is this the church? I said, pardon me? Is this the church? I said, yes, ma'am. What time y'all service? I said, oh, we not. She said, oh, okay. Because my name and my number's on the website, you know, because we're not in a physical building. And she called me this morning, woke me up. Amen. Langston, I thought it was my grandson who's staying the weekend with her. Langston Lester, I think the name was. I said, who is this? She said, where y'all church at? Where y'all church at? So call me. my number's on the world wide web. Call me. Just like she called this morning and was trying to get the church. You call me right now. I said, Pastor Golden, I want to join the church. Amen. Be all right. Amen. Is there one in this hour, in this moment? Amen. I'm taking my time. Amen. To make sure, amen, we get everybody that wants to in here today. Amen. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Oh, my soul and all that is within me. Come on, let somebody just clap your hands in the joy of the Lord, won't you? Amen. Clap your hand in the joy of the Lord. Amen. We're having great church here today, and we've had a great time already. Already, amen. Amen. We're preparing now for the right hand of fellowship. Pastor Golden and Deacon Hoover and Deacon Palin and our officers are going to give you a big welcome. Amen. We know we have one candidate here. We're so excited about it. And look like Chair Hoover, she's brought a whole church herself. Amen. And I want to know, Deacon Hoover, if before you announce her, or you can go ahead and announce it, but I want to know also who all these people that she done invited here today. I want to know every one of them. Amen. So let me tell them right now, put some lipstick on your forehead. Amen. Put a smile, because we get ready to put that camera spotlight you, because we want to see you, Miss Tracy and brother, whoever y'all are. Amen. Every one of it, we want to know exactly who you is. Amen. As you come here to be with your sister or your cousin or your friend, whatever the relationship is. Amen. Come on, Chair Hoover. Let's lift this beautiful sister up here today. Amen.
Morning, Pastor Golden.
Or Deacon Palin.
Will I allow Deacon Palin to come forward? Deacon Palin.
Good morning, everyone. Pastor, you want to get the guests before I do the right hand or after?
Yes, please. I want to know. Yes, ma'am, please.
Right. Okay. So Sister Kiva, good morning. I see you do have some friends here today, and I'm going to ask you to introduce them. That way we'll know specifically who they are. Unmute. Okay. Still muted. Right. It's still
okay. Muted. Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
I had to go over to another one. I was prepared.
Wonderful.
And let me see, was there Tracy? That's my cousin.
All righty.
We got Rhonda, family.
Uh-huh.
Eric, Ashley. Ashley's my cousin.
All righty.
Okay, let me go to the next page. Asia's my sister.
All right.
And I had someone else on here. There was an Anitra and it was a Kim Wiggins. Mm-hmm. They're my friends.
What's the relationship there?
They're both my friends. Like
both friends. Okay. Yes. Wonderful. How about Ashley? Is Ashley related to you?
Yes. Ashley's my cousin. That's Rhonda's daughter.
I know that. I'm just trying to see if you're going to claim it.
Yeah.
All right. Wonderful. Yes.
Okay, Sister Kiva, do you have your Bible and your certificate handy?
I do.
Okay. So Pastor Golden, New Unity members and friends, we are pleased to present one candidate who will receive the right hand of fellowship this morning. She is Sister Nakiba Salem. Sister Salem, on today, we make two presentations to you. The first, the Bible, God's Holy Word. This Bible has been signed by our pastor and our first lady.
Yeah.
Read it, study it, and let it serve as a lamp and a light as you live your life for God. The second presentation is your certificate, if you can hold it up. It reads, this certifies that Sister Nakiba Salem received the right hand of fellowship on this 27th day of February in the year of our Lord, 2022. Reverend Johnny N. Golden, Senior Pastor, Servant Leader, Deacon Tamara Randolph, Church Administrator. And so Sister Salem, as Peter, James, and John gave the right hand of fellowship to Paul and Barnabas, we, Pastor Golden, First Lady Wanda Golden, Deacons Hoover, Kearney, High, and Randolph, extend a virtual right hand of fellowship
to That's you, right.
touching and agreeing that we serve God together. Amen. And now our chair of laity, Deacon Millicent Hoover, will come and extend an official welcome to our newest member.
Sister Kiba, Sister Kiba,
yes.
We are grateful to the Lord that you are now a part of this great New Unity family. We thank you, Sister Kiba, that you've already learned one of the greatest lessons about being saved, and that is to go and tell somebody else.
Yeah.
As today you had here your little sister, as they say, Asia, and you had your friends, Kim, and your friends, Tracy. And you had all your first cousins, Erica, Ashley, Tierra, James, Nigel. And not only there, you didn't stop there. You invited friends and co-workers. And then you had your cousin Tanya here today. And then the matriarch of this family, our very own Deacon Rhonda Thomas, with the gaggle that she's brought here with us. We stand in agreement with you today. And just know, Sister Kiba, we claim you. We've been claiming you since you was little, when your mother came and prayed for you. And so we're just glad to have you back with us again. We know God has great things in store for you on the horizon with your entrepreneurship. Just know this New Unity Church stands with you and we support you. Whether you move all the way to Atlanta or whether you stay right here in Windsor Mill, we are with you. And we stand with you. We love you. We surround you with the love that comes from Jesus. And so we say to you, sis, go tell somebody else.
Yeah.
This goodness that the Lord has done in your life, go and tell somebody else. Welcome, welcome, welcome to the great and glorious New Unity Baptist Church. We have Bible study on Wednesdays. We have prayer meeting on Saturday morning at 7 a.m. We have a Sunday school class on the first and third Sundays with your name on it.
Yeah.
Please, please, please get involved and stay involved, and we'll work together one with another. God bless you and heaven smile upon you. Let's shake our hands, leaders. Let's all shake our hands virtually.
Thank you.
And amen. God bless you.
And Sister Kiba, again, we do welcome you. Thank God for we see the tears coming down your cheek, and that makes us feel good. Amen. To see you. Yeah, to know that is real. Amen. And we used to sing a song in the church of yesteryear. And I was talking about the worship leaders and the griots and the singers of yesterday, we used to sing a song, makes you move, makes you shout, make you cry. Amen. Deep within, I got that burning, yearning feeling, that power that come from above. It makes you move, it makes you shout, it makes you come within. Yeah, that old time religion. And so we bless the Lord for you this morning, Kiba. We love you. We thank God for you. And don't you let nobody turn you around now on this last Sunday of Black History Month. Amen. Not everybody, but most people, sophisticated people up north, Sister Kiba, when they sing in the song, they say gonna, G-O-N-N-N-A, ain't gonna let nobody turn me around. But I'm from South Carolina. I'm from the South. And down South, we don't say gonna. We put a W in there. It's G-W-O-N-A. Ain't guana. ain't gonna let nobody turn me around, no, turn me around, turn me around. Ain't gonna let, so you gonna, don't you gonna let nobody keep, I don't care what they say, whoever it is. And when you tell them my pastor, well, he won't beat you up, but he'll beat you up in the spirit. My pastor will bop you in the spirit, amen. He won't fight you in the physical, but he'll bop you in the spirit, amen. You don't want to fight with God, amen. Remind them their arms are too short to box with God. God bless you. We love you. We appreciate you. Amen, amen, and amen. Now I'm coming, Deacon Rosa Porter, amen, our mother, to share along with Deacon Philip Randolph in the reading of the scripture, amen, in the church covenant. As we prepare now to come to the table, we have our elements. Deacon Porter, we are ready to receive from you now.
All right, church, having been led by the Spirit of God to receive the Lord Jesus Christ as our Savior,
yeah,
and on the profession of our faith, having been baptized in the name of the Father,
yeah,
and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, we pledge to give this church a place in our affection, prayers, and service above every organization of human origin, to sustain its worship, ordinance, discipline, and doctrine, to contribute cheerfully and regularly to, as God has prospered us towards its expenses for the support of a faithful and evangelical ministry,
yeah,
among us, the relief of the poor and spread of the gospel throughout the world. In case of difference of opinions in the church, we will strive to avoid a contentious spirit. And if we cannot unanimously agree, we will cheerfully recognize the rights of the majority to govern. We further engage to guard each other's reputation,
yeah,
not needlessly exposing the infirmities of others.
That's right.
To participate in each other's joys and with tender sympathy bear one another's burdens and sorrows.
All right, cultivate.
To cultivate Christian courtesy,
yeah,
to be slow to give or take offense, but always ready for reconciliation, being mindful of the rules of the Savior in the 18th chapter of Matthew, to secure it without delay.
Yeah.
And throughout life, amidst its evil reports and good reports, to live to the glory of God, who has called us out of darkness
into
marvelous light. When we remove from this place,
uh-huh,
we engage as soon as possible to unite with some other church where we can carry out the spirit of this covenant and the principles of God's word. Amen.
Thank you, Mother. All right, Deacon Philip Randolph.
I will now be reading the sacred instructions for the Lord's Supper found in 1 Corinthians, the 11th chapter, verses 23 through 33. Again, that's 1 Corinthians, chapter 11, verses 23 through 33. For I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread.
Yeah.
And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, take, eat. This is my body, which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me. After the same manner also, he took the cup. And when he had supped, saying, this cup is the New Testament in my blood. this day, this doing ye, as often as ye drink it, in remembrance of me. For as often as ye eat this bread and drink this cup, ye do show the Lord's death till he come. Wherefore, whosoever shall eat this bread and drink this cup of the Lord unworthily shall be guilty of the body and blood of the Lord. But let every man examine himself, and so let him eat of that bread and drink of that cup. For he that eateth and drinketh unworthily eateth and drinketh damnation to himself, not discerning the Lord's body. For this cause, many are weak and sickly among you, and many sleep. For if we should judge ourselves, we should not be judged. But when we are judged, we are chastened of the Lord, that we should not be condemned with the world. Last verse. Wherefore, my brethren, when you come together to eat, tarry one for another. The word of God for the people of God.
Amen. Thank you so very much. Amen. As Deacon Hoover now, and along with Deacon Kearney, ordered the table properly, been unveiled by Deacon Bennett and Deacon Palin. Amen. Now we have blessed the table. Reverend Golden has blessed the table. You hold your elements now in your hand. Amen. Receive them. Amen. They are holy. They are sacred for the people of God. As we take this wafer, amen. Amen. We take this wafer, we present it to the Lord, everything that we receive in this life, everything which you get, including your children. Amen. You remember that from roots. You always present it to the Lord. Give it back to him as Hannah did with young Samuel, as we do with everything that we receive from God. Amen. We present it back to him. Amen. Even in the final rite, R-I-T-E, of life at the funeral, we always say, from dust you have come and dust you have returned. So everything that we get in this life, we give it back to God. Amen. We lift up this wafer representing his body broken for you, broken for me. Amen. We lift it up. We bless it. We thank you, O God, for this bread from heaven, this bread from heaven, this wow factor beyond human imagination. How is it possible that if we eat this wafer, we consume this, your body representative, we can live forever? But we know that when this old life is over, we're going to another home. Receive it now, Lord. We receive this in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Receive it, church, in Jesus' name. Amen. Receive you the wafer. Break it and receive. The scripture said that in like manner, he took the cup. Amen. The cup being the wine, in our case being the juice. Amen. The libation that we pour out before him, amen, the libation of oblation, that is to say the liquid form of our sacrifice, we lift it up to God, amen, you pull back, amen, and we lift it up to God, and again, we also bless God and thank him for it. Lord, we bless your name once again. We thank you for the blood, oh, the blood, and we ask you, God, to receive us now as we receive it. Thank you for Sister Nakiba Salem, her family, this great cloud of witnesses that surround her and surround all of us today. We thank you, O God, in Jesus' name. We receive and now repeat these words. And I, if I,
if I
be lifted up from the earth, I'll draw all men unto me. Amen. Receive ye the cup of the Lord, church. Amen. From our earliest youth, we've always been taught whenever someone does something for you, take a moment to say thank you. And so we take this moment now to say thank you to Jesus. Thank you to the Father. Amen. For sending his Son. Thank you that he came. And when he departed, he sent us the Holy Ghost, the Spirit to dwell in us. And so we are wrapped in the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. And his Holy Spirit abides in us. In Jesus' name. In the name of the Father, who is the head of our life. In the name of the Son, who is the center of our joy, in the name of the Holy Spirit, who covers us in all things, we say amen, amen, and amen. Well, wait a moment now. As Sister Cindy Cover in the Spirit comes to snuff out the candles that we have lit, amen. We're thanking God for Brother Jeffrey Henderson as he has brought us the elements, the basin, amen. Now, Sister Cindy in the Spirit snuffs out the candles, amen. We return the Book of Jubilee, and we sing the chant. We talked about the songs of yesteryear. Let's sing the chant now as we prepare to go to our seats for our clothes. Amen. Oh, the blood. Oh, the blood. Oh, the blood done signed my name. Oh, the blood. Oh, the blood. Oh, the blood done signed my name. Oh, the blood. Oh, the blood. Oh, the blood done signed my name. Oh, the blood done signed my name. Ain't you glad? Ain't you glad? Ain't you glad? Ain't you glad that the blood done signed your name? Ain't you glad? Ain't you glad that the blood done signed your name? Ain't you glad? Ain't you glad that the blood done signed your name? Oh, the blood done signed your name. Amen. Shake hands with somebody, won't you? In the spirit. Amen. Virtually. And then as you return to your places, as we prepare now, amen, for our benediction. Amen. And we prepare to go home from here. Amen. We're coming down from a high mountain today. Oh, we've been up. I tell you, and the higher you go, you know, for a lot of us, the scarier it is. Isn't that right? Amen. It's okay at ground level. But boy, you go higher. I remember many years ago when we were downtown and we had an afternoon service. It may have been Holy Communion. I just don't remember. Brother Lenny and I climbed all the way to the top of the Washington Monument there, Mount Vernon. I mean, to the very top. I think Lenny went to the top. I think he did. I'm not sure. He might have got weary along the way. But I know I climbed all the way to the very top, looked out the window. Amen. I was just telling my mother and my wife yesterday that in Washington, D.C., Brother Williams, that no building in Washington, D.C. can ever be taller than the Washington Monument. No building. Trump Tower is nothing. 555 feet is the height of the Washington Monument. And I don't care if you got $1 billion or the President of the United States or whatever, you can never build any structure in D.C. higher than the Washington Monument. Well, but one day we're going to fly over that monument. We're going to another place. Amen. God be praised. Well, it's been a great day, hasn't it? We've been on the mountain, Dr. Day. I mean, we've been on the mountain today. Anybody eat anybody getting any fresh bread today? I tried to bring some fresh bread today, not some day-old bread. I've been struggling with that woman. Jesus called that woman a dog. Amen. I had to read that and study that several times. Amen. So now I got to make some sense out of this for the people of God. But the only time Jesus said, "You right," and Jesus had to say, "My bad," is when that woman confronted him. Ain't that something? And she said, "Yea, Lord, but even the dogs eat the crumbs from fall from the master's table." Woo! Now that's... Isn't that something? Yea, Lord, but even the dogs eat the crumbs that fall from the master's table. That's a powerful text. Don't forget now reading Isaiah 53 this week. That's right. We're praying. Try to find 10 minutes. People say, I can't do it, Pastor. I say you can if you want to. Even on your job, even at home, even at work. If some of you got a second job, don't you? You can find 10 minutes to say, "I got 10 minutes, amen, that I need to talk to the Lord." Amen. Find that 10 minutes. And I guarantee you, if you try, the Lord will make it possible. But you got to try, right? You got to try. And as you're trying, he'll make it possible. Find that 10 minutes. You can read your Bible, talk to the Lord, and you're going to have a great week this week. Put it in the chat. We're closing now. Last thing we're going to say, put it in the chat. I'm going to have a great week this week. Come on. I'm going to have a great week this week. Just put it in there. That means the devil going to jump on you as soon as we say goodnight. Oh, hello. But you're going to tell the devil, "Get out of here, devil. Get out of here." We're going to have a great week. I'm going to have a great week this week. Amen. By the grace of God. Yes, we are. We're claiming it by faith. Thank you, New Unity. All of you, Deacon Hoover, Deacon Kearney, Deacon Jackson, Deacon Randolph. All of our MTM, Deacon Palin, Deacon Vanessa Thomas, just scanning the screens. I mean, I'm overlooked. Deacon High, everybody that had anything to do with helping to pull this service together. And I told the church the other night, I'm a producer, but it's a production. It really is. But thank you, everyone. Deacon Porter, for your reading. Anybody else I'm overlooking, just know I don't have a script in front of me. But thank you, every one of you, for helping us, Brother Aaron, Brother Tyler, Sister Andrea, I know I'm probably leaving out two or three other persons, but thank God for every one of you, Sister Kiba, for all of your family and friends who joined us. Thank you, every one of you. Enjoy the rest of this day. Amen. We'll see everybody Wednesday. Now, don't forget to bring your blood droplets, right? Locate that envelope, amen, wherever it may be. Reach inside, amen. Get your droplet, bring it out on Wednesday night, amen, as we join together, amen. Let's have a great time as we begin this Lenten season. Isaiah 53, we're reading this week. Isaiah 53, taking a time to get closer to the Lord, amen, amen. If anyone or listed on our program, I don't want to overlook anyone for our benediction. All right, as it is, I think it's Pastor Golden today, so God be praised. Amen. Again, we salute you, Sister Kiba, Mother Virginia Woodley, Sister Porter, all of our saints. So blessed yesterday to get that phone call from you, Sister Edna Abram. Thank you for calling, Pastor. We love you. We appreciate you. Amen. Sister Janie, and to all of Brother Henry Beard and every one of you. Won't call every name today, but thank God for every one of you once again. Now let's lift that right hand to God, shall we? Now to him who is able to present us faultless and to keep us from falling, to him, the only wise God, our Father, be, somebody say, GMDP, glory, majesty, dominion, and power. Amen. Henceforth for now, the bread of life. Amen, amen, and amen. Let's sing it together. Praise God. Praise him. Amen, amen, and amen. Amen, amen. Amen, amen. Go in peace, New Unity. Have a great day, everybody. Have a great, great, great day. Amen.